This instructional video demonstrates the use of Yeti Dental's K2 Lee Press Ceramic. It is absolutely necessary to fix the sprue on the thickest part of your wax up. Never fix the sprue at a thin part of the labial side of your modulation. Always press from thick to thin. If you press from thin to thick, the ceramic will be too viscous, and the crystals will become wedged together at the thin area. This can lead to whitish coloring like a ring around the attachment area of the sprue. The angle when fixing the object on the base should be 45 degrees. Fix the sprue in axial pressing direction. The pressed framework should never be thinner than the layer thickness of the veneering ceramic. It ensures the stability of the construction. The pressed framework should be at least 50% of the total thickness of the construction. If you don't follow the specifications, this can lead to cracks or fractures of the restoration. We recommend the use of the K2 Press Universal Investment Material. Make sure to follow the instructions of the investment manufacturer. For the best fitting, please store the investment material at about 20 degrees Celsius. We recommend to use the vibrator on the softest level. Fill the silicon cylinder to the upper ring inside before you close it with the mold gauge. Don't move the cylinder during the setting time. Remove the silicon cylinder, base and gauge. Remove and straighten excess with a knife for better stand and degassing. When pressing a single ingot, place the ingot in the cylinder with the logo print facing upwards. When using two ingots, remove the logo print from the first one, which can be easily achieved by sandblasting. Otherwise, it can lead to discoloration. If the pressing temperature is too low, the object is not completely pressed. If the pressing temperature is too high, you get a strong reaction layer. Raise or lower the temperature in steps of 5 degrees Celsius. Cool down the pressed cylinder at room temperature only. Faster cooling can lead to cracks. Blast with 50 micron glass beads with a maximum of 4 bar pressure. As soon as the object becomes visible, continue with a maximum of 2 to 3 bar pressure. make sure that the reaction layer is completely removed. Depending on the press result and furnace, the press temperatures must be readjusted. The higher the pressing temperature, the larger the reaction layer, and the harder it is to remove it. If the reaction layer is too strong, lower the temperature. Increase the temperature in case of defects in the pressing. Further information can be found on our website at yeti-dental.com. Thank you for watching and have a wonderful day.